Hello everyone, this is the Wildfox. And this time of year is Christmas time, we all know. It's a time of good tidings and good cheer and, well, all that other stuff too, or so they say. Now, me personally, I don't really celebrate the holidays this year. I don't celebrate Christmas or any type of holiday in December, but that's just me personally. I'm just going to leave it at that. I have my reasons. But one thing I will say is I do enjoy some aspects of this year, namely the holiday specials that appear during this month. Back in the 80s and 90s, there were a number of holiday specials that appeared on network television. Some we remember and, well, some we don't remember. And today, I'm going to take a look at one that hardly anyone ever remembers. Because it only aired just one time. Today, we're going to take a look at Santa Bear's High Flying Adventure.
If there's a place where all your dreams come true, you're never alone.
This special was brought to us by Rabbit Ears Productions, famous for giving us so many children's stories throughout the years. It premiered back on Christmas Eve in 1987 on CBS, and only aired just that one day. Really a shame too, because it's one of those rare Christmas specials that has a really good message to it. I guess because it didn't have an abundance of commercialism in it. Talking about you, Grandma! It fails to capture an audience. But those of us that do remember it well and the message it conveys. What's interesting to me about this special is the voices that they got for the main cast. The special features the voices of Kelly McGinnis, most famous for her roles as Charlie in Top Gun, Catherine Murphy in The Accused, and Rachel from Witness. John Malkovich, if you can believe it, voices Santa Claus in this special. But the one that gets me the most is Bobby McFerrin voicing both Santa Bear and Bully Bear in this special. And no, folks, I'm not making this up. I actually did some extensive research into this. Bobby McFerrin, the same man who's responsible for giving us this.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy.
It's behind the main hero and the main villain. Honestly, with this formula, this special should have caught on and been aired more than once. But no one remembers it. Well, it's time to either jog your memory or rekindle them because we're going to dive right into this special right now. Our special starts with a song sequence. Oh, wait a minute, I almost forgot to mention something. This song, plus all the music for this special, was the responsibility of one Felix Cavalier, vocalist, keyboardist of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame band, The Rascals. Oh, for bloody sake, there's so many famous people working on this special. How did it not find an audience? Anyway, during the title sequence, we see our main hero in the snow being engulfed into a large snowball as it steers him to Santa's workshop. Inside the workshop, elves are hard at work making toys for Santa to deliver on Christmas Eve night.
Santa Bear.
Look what I found.
You mean?
You've been out in the snow all this time?
On the eve of Christmas Eve?
When we're as busy as can be.
And that's all you've got to show for it?
It may not seem like much to you, but to someone who lost them.
He returns the sneakers to a mouse who's working the treadmill and is complimented on his kindness by Santa Claus.
You're welcome, sir.
Later that night, everyone takes a group photo to be hung on the wall, and Santa Bear notices a snow bear similar looking to him in one of the photos.
Santa Bear, you and the bear in this picture may look alike, but you are not at all alike. You see, once I was wrong about a Santa's helper. This bear was my mistake.
Who is he?
He goes by the name of Bully Bear.
What did he do?
Bully Bear tried to steal every last Christmas present for himself.
Every single one? But that's more than anyone could ever possibly play with. And what about everybody else?
Bully Bear only cares about himself. That's why I asked him to leave. But he was very angry and said he would find a way to make everyone stop believing in me and ruin Christmas forever. Now, Santa Bear, no one has seen or heard from Bully Bear since last Christmas. But if you ever see him or anything suspicious, you must come to me right away.
I will, Santa. I promise.
Before he goes to sleep, Santa Bear sings a lullaby he made up himself to the mouse he returned his sneakers to earlier.
The world can be so very wide. Can make you feel so small inside.
rest of it go?
I don't know yet. You see, I've been making it up as I go along.
Couldn't you sing just a little bit more?
I'd like to be right by your side, for you to bear in mind.
The next morning, everyone is loading their presents at the Santa sleigh when Santa Bear notices something in the sack.
Oh, Santa Claus, I saw someone in there. Someone with eyes exactly like mine.
Bully Bear.
I didn't think all of them could fit in there. That's impressive.
Why, Santa Bear, you just saw yourself.
Ooh, that's some impressive wrapping paper, I must say. With everything ready, Santa Claus and Santa Bear take off as they approach a very snowy land.
Look down. Way down. That is the South Pole.
That's an honor call, right?
That is why I would like you, my special helper, to bring this sack of presents to that lonely place. You see, Santa Bear, all the creatures at the South Pole are not so sure there's such a thing as Christmas. Life is so hard there that they don't know whether to believe in me or not.
You mean it's hard for them to keep up the Christmas spirit all year round? Well, I'll do my best to convince them, Santa Claus. You can count on me.
With those last words, Santa Bear parachutes down to the South Pole. On land, he spots a village in the distance and makes his way there when he comes across a familiar tune being sung by a female pilot fixing her airplane.
Excuse me, about that song you're singing, how does the rest of it go?
Who wants to know?
My name is Santa Bear, and I'm an official Santa's helper, all the way from the North Pole.
Official?
Santa Claus gave me these when he made me his official helper.
Well, I don't think you're going to like the South Pole. It's the farthest place from Christmas in the whole wide world.
That's why I'm here. I was on my way to deliver presents when I heard you singing my song.
Your song? I made it up.
That's impossible. I made it up.
I wonder who's telling the truth here. Why don't you sing it for us?
You know that I will always love.
We'll always want to be part of.
We'll always hold so high above. The one I bear in mind.
Looks like it's high to me.
Who are you?
My name is Missy.
Missy? How do you do?
Did you say you came here all by yourself?
That's right. Santa dropped me.
And you brought a big red and green sack of presents tied up with a gold rope?
That's it. Right over there.
All of a sudden, a pair of legs pop out of the sack and runs away from them. Santa Bear joins Missy as the two get chasing her plane. The plane, however.
Are you sure you know what you're doing?
Nothing to it.
It's heading south. Is that where your family lives?
I have no family. I'm an orphan. Here we go!
With one last tweak, they're back on track and catch up to the sack as Santa Bear reaches down to retrieve it. Or so he thinks. The sack grabs onto the wing, causing the plane to spiral out of control and then crash land into a snow dune, knocking Missy unconscious. As Santa Bear comes to, the figure in the bag emerges.
Haven't I seen you somewhere before? Allow me to introduce myself. Bully Bear!
As if there were any doubt, I guess.
You followed me all the way from the North Pole, didn't you? You hid in the sack.
That was pretty fast, and Santa Bear wasn't even paying attention to what was going on.
Why are you doing this? What do you want?
Revenge. Santa Claus will soon find out that Bully Bear doesn't take no for an answer.
The way I figure it, there's only one thing worse than getting no Christmas presents at all, and that is getting broken, ruined, used up presents that are absolutely no use to anyone.
How awful. You'll destroy everyone's faith in Santa Claus, and it'll be my fault. Where's Missy? What have you done with her?
If I were you, I'd worry about the fact that you and your pal Santa Claus were about to be out of a job. Permanently.
Soon after the police arrive and Missy recovers, they both easily mistake Santa Bear for Bully Bear, and the real Bully has no problem slipping past the authorities.
I guess I'm on my own again.
Santa Bear is thrown in jail, and Missy departs with a present from Santa Claus. She starts to sing the song, which gives Santa Bear an idea to sing back, calling to her.
The weather's different every day. What comes around must go away. But you can count on me to stay. I'll always bear in mind. I wonder if there'll come a time.
It must be. It can only be.
I keep
Santa Bear, where are you? I'm coming, Santa Bear. Don't stop singing.
Realizing the bear in jail is the real Santa Bear, she breaks him out and tries to fly them both out of there. However,
we have to go back and stop Bully Bear before he ruins Christmas forever.
Forget Christmas. It's dangerous down there.
Don't you see? If there isn't any Christmas at the South Pole, then anyone who isn't very nice might think that they can put a stop to Christmas anytime, until there isn't any Christmas at all, any place in the world. If you won't come back with me, I'll have to go back there myself.
With that, Missy's convinced, and they go back down to the village after Bully Bear. Meanwhile in the village, Bully Bear puts his plan into motion.
You can just see the looks on their faces. I can just hear what they'll say about Santa Claus after this.
But luckily, Santa Bear and Missy make it in time to stop the broken toy from going down a chimney. But Bully Bear's not done yet.
Bully Bear, no!
Missy recovers the sack, and Santa Bear gives chase to Bully Bear across the rooftops of the village until Bully Bear makes one bad jump.
If you let me go, I'll give you anything you want. Anything.
I made a promise to Santa Claus, and that means more to me than anything. This has gone far enough, Bully Bear. Let me help you up. I suppose I don't have much choice.
Okay, we all knew that was coming. But thankfully, Missy has a flotation raft stored away, and she tosses it to the police so that they can catch the two without their attire. At that moment, Santa Claus arrives and has to tell the two apart.
Now, each of you, in your own words, tell me the meaning of Christmas.
Something for nothing. Getting presents.
Wrong answer, sir. And you, sir?
Giving presents. Especially the ones you can't wrap.
Well, I think we have our winner, folks.
Sooner or later, everyone shows their true colors. Perhaps now you finally realize that you're responsible for everything that you say and do.
Even the things that nobody sees you say or do?
Especially the things nobody else knows about. Everything counts. I don't believe we've met.
This is Missy Santa Claus. She's my very best friend. If she hadn't helped me...
It was nothing.
No, it was something, all right. It seems to me you deserve a very special Christmas present. And I know just the thing. You have a family now. Ours.
And so our special ends with our heroes departing the village, now in Christmas spirit, and Bully Bear in jail, peeling potatoes. As I mentioned earlier, it's a shame this special didn't get a lot of airtime after its only premiere. I mean, the animation might not be top-notch, and the voice acting can sound dull at times, but the message behind it is obviously the best part. I mean, seriously, would you rather have your children watching this during the holiday season, or would you rather have them watching this? Personally, I'll take this one any day of the week. But this one, though, can die in a fire.
High above, the one I bear in mind.
Bully for Christmas.